Greetings. Have you heard about the tribulation? Do you know where the term comes from? Jesus was teaching in Mark 13:14. But when you shall see the abomination of desolation spoken of by Daniel the prophet, standing where it ought not, let him that readeth understand. And then Jesus continues teaching. But he mentions the abomination of desolation spoken of by Daniel the prophet. So what is the abomination of desolation? And where does Daniel mention it? In Daniel 9:27, And he shall confirm the covenant with many for 1 week, and in the midst of the week he shall cause the sacrifice and the oblation to cease, and for the overspreading of abominations he shall make it desolate, even until the consummation. And he shall confirm the covenant with many for 1 week. The actual word used here, translated week, is really a word that means a seven, or a period of seven. It is logically understood to mean a period of 7 years. This 7 years is also called the tribulation. The teaching of the 7-year tribulation was popularized or made widely known in the common culture by the Left Behind series. It's pretty popular in Christian circles today, but I'd like to look at one thing more closely. To understand the meaning, we must examine the context. Daniel 9:20. And while I was speaking and praying and confessing my sins and the sin of my people Israel, and presenting my supplication before the Lord my God for the holy mountain of my God, yea, while I was speaking in prayer, even the man Gabriel, whom I had seen in the vision at the beginning, being caused to fly swiftly, touched me about the time of the evening oblation. And he informed me, and talked with me, and said, O Daniel, I am now come forth to give thee skill and understanding. At the beginning of thy supplications, the commandment came forth, and I am come to show thee, for thou art greatly beloved. Therefore understand the matter and consider the vision. Gabriel is about to give Daniel, the prophet, a prophetic revelation, or a vision. And here it goes. 70 weeks are determined upon thy people and upon thy holy city to finish the transgression and to make an end of sins and to make reconciliation for iniquity and to bring in everlasting righteousness and to seal up the vision and prophecy and to anoint the most holy. Here's the point that I think has been completely missed. Books like the Left Behind fiction series portray the tribulation as global, the whole world in turmoil. But look at verse 24 again, Daniel 9:24. 70 weeks are determined upon thy people and upon thy holy city, Jerusalem. Huh? What? Look at it again. 70 weeks are determined upon thy people and upon thy holy city, Jerusalem. It does not say Jerusalem, but thy holy city is Jerusalem. That is how Jerusalem is referred to. Now, I am often very critical when Mohammedans abused the context of verses in the Bible. I must also judge evenly when I judge how Christians abuse the context, which leads me to my main point. I think the 7-year tribulation is a vision of events which happen to Jewish people. The 7-year tribulation is a vision of events in Jerusalem, perhaps as broad as Israel, but not globally. If the pattern we are looking for is the global cataclysm of the Left Behind series, I think we could miss it. Think about that. 70 weeks are determined upon thy people and upon thy holy city. That seems pretty clear who this vision is specifically pertaining to. Let's receive God's prophetic messages like He sent them. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.